Being rich does not guarantee that you're going to give birth to kids that are well-mannered and well-behaved. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time stopping by my channel, my name is Nella Mbocha. You're welcome to my channel. And if you're my returning subscriber, welcome back to the channel. So guys, today is another movie review and the title of this movie is Rich Mom, Poor Mom. I know that a lot of you might have come across this movie, but if you've not, you're welcome to my channel. Let's dive right into the review. Before I start, permit me to clap for Destiny Itiker. Guys, Destiny Itiker is doing well, I must confess. Destiny Itiker is doing really well. I mean, this movie is worth it. This movie is really, really worth it. This movie is a movie that every parent, every family should watch. Like, you should watch this movie. You feel you are rich, and even if you're poor, like, just try your best to watch this movie. And if you're rich, try your best to watch this movie and put more effort on the way you're training your kids, because like I said from the beginning of this movie, or from the beginning of this video, being rich does not guarantee that you're going to have kids that are well-mannered and well-behaved, because some rich kids, most rich kids, or let me say some rich kids so that I will not offend anybody, some rich kids do not actually have manners. You would agree with me, you that is watching this video, you would agree with me that some rich kids are not well-mannered. Not that being poor guarantees a child to be well-mannered, well-trained, and all the goodies, right? But then, some rich kids are actually ill-mannered. Like, some rich kids do not actually have manners at all. So guys, let me start by appreciating all the actors in this movie. All the actors and actresses did really great. From Chinenye Nnebe to Destiny Itiker to Karen to Candice to the Sierra Leonean guy to the house help, everybody, to the gate man, everybody did so well. Chinenye Nnebe is one girl that does so well in every character. Like, she does so well with every character. Any character you give her, she's gonna kill it. She acted so well as a mom. Candice, Karen, God. I mean, at some point I was thinking, are you guys sure that this is not how this girl actually behaves in reality? Because she played her character so well. She played her character. She killed it 100. She killed her character 100. Then, Candice, on the other hand, did so well with her character as well. Like, they all did so well with their characters. The house help played her character 100%. Like, they did so well. This movie is a story of two girls. One was born in a rich home and one was born in a poor home. But the one that was born in a poor home was very well-mannered and very intelligent. She was very, very intelligent when it comes to her books, right? But then she had no opportunity to actually be in school. But the rich kid was enrolled in a school that they pay over 1 million naira every term. Yet she knows nothing. Like, she really, really knows nothing. And to make it all worse, she is very, very ill-mannered. Like, she is very, very ill-mannered. The person that played this character, the character of the ill-mannered child, was Karen Ibinigun, if I actually got that right. But her name is Karen. She's a very, very smart kid. Like, she played her character so well. So, as I was saying, the one that was enrolled in a school where they pay 1 million naira, over 1 million naira every term, was actually the one that knows nothing. Like, she does not make good grades in school. All her grades were 0, 0, 0. At a point, she started using her hands to take herself good. Like she would change her grades from bad to good, just for her parents to be impressed with her. Like, she was so immature and bitter. And this girl, I wouldn't say that was the way she was raised, because after all, her parents are trying so well. They enrolled her in a school, in a very good school, and they are trying in terms of, you know, correcting her when she's wrong. But then she just chose to be a sports brat, because her mom would always, you know, caution her, don't do this, this is not the way to talk to your elder son. But I think the father was obliging her more. Okay, the mom was trying to, you know, correct her, but I really do feel that if I was in her mom's shoe, I would have done better. And then her father, on the other hand, was kind of obliging her. So I really do feel the way they trained her was, you know, okay, the way they trained her actually contributed to her character. So the poor girl, on the other hand, this Mintico's child, Candice, was very, very well-mannered and very intelligent. She was not in school yet, but she was very, very intelligent. So what brought the connection between the two families was the fact that Chinenyebe, Karen's mom, actually lost her daughter, and the daughter she lost actually looks so well like Candice. So whenever she sees Candice on the streets, she would just be so carried away and be looking at her. You know, she would, you know, start crying. Candice actually reminds her of her dead daughter. So Candice and her mom, Desnetico, actually later came to live with Chinenyebe and her husband and kids. Chinenyebe's husband actually brought them from the streets to their home to, you know, start working for them as their house help. But due to the fact that their daughter actually do not like associating with anybody, she's so rude and all of that, she didn't like the fact that they were in their house. She was always complaining that they are dirty and stuff. So, but then her parents insisted that they would stay. So they gave this Netiko a job in their house and also enrolled their daughter in their rude daughter's school. She felt so disappointed, and then she decided that, okay, you want to stay in our house, right? I'm going to show you better. So it went on and on, and although she later changed, she later became a better person, she later apologized to the girl. At some point, I thought that Karen was actually like that naturally, because I was really scared for her, because the way she played her character was so, like, she played it like that is who she is, right? So, but then when she later changed in this movie, I now saw that this is not actually who this girl is. It's just the character that she's portraying, right? That she's playing in the movie. So when Karen later became friends with Candice, she started loving Candice, and then Candice started teaching her manners and even how to pass her exams. Like, she started teaching her how to do her assignments and get it right. She started teaching her manners. She literally taught her how to be a good girl and not to be rude. So being rich does not guarantee that your child is going to be well mannered. Guys, rush down to Chinemelo's TV to see the full movie. This movie is actually worth your time and data. Like, it's worth your time and data. Please give this video a thumbs up. It helps the algorithm to actually show this video to a lot of persons. So guys, Also subscribe and share, comment your thoughts on this movie. See you guys on the next one. Bye.